Welcome to a brand new Let's Play. We're going to actually be playing a multiplayer version of Small World 2, which is a game that is being developed by Days of Wonder, and we actually have all of the DLC installed. And I'll introduce you to each of the players. Well, I'll start with myself, I guess. I'm Das24680, and I'll introduce the next player, who'll be Marcus Aurelius.
Hello, everyone.
And Marcus, we've sort of come together, I guess, through, you know, games like Dominion and that, where we've sort of been sort of following each other, I imagine, and so we sort of decided to actually put this little game together. So is there anything else you wanted to sort of talk about as far as Small World 2, like your history with the game or anything else?
Well, yeah, I've played the game as a board game, so I was actually a Kickstarter backer of the digital game when I heard about it, and so I'm just excited to see what it's like.
That's fantastic. So when did you kickstart the game? Because it's been on Kickstarter for a little while, I think, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I honestly couldn't say, maybe about a year ago.
Wow, okay.
I had a big Kickstarter binge about February or March.
And I'll introduce the third player. Third player is Tokshen, and Tokshen and I have been sort of involved in a Dominion's multiplayer game just recently, actually, that finished. And so we've now, Tokshen actually contacted me about when he saw that I had a small World 2 video on. So do you want to say hello, Tokshen, and maybe give a little bit of a background with the game as well?
Yeah, sure. Hey, everybody. How's it going? Tokshen here. My background with this game is I purchased Small World, the actual board game, and all of its expansions earlier this year, and it really kind of got me into the board game scene. And I honestly think that Small World is an amazing game for like an introduction to anybody who's kind of curious about board games, because it's really easy to learn, but there are a lot of strategies involved in it too. So yeah, it's a great game. I love it. And I'm very happy to be playing the PC version that I did not kickstart, because I honestly didn't even know this was going to be a game until about last month or so. But okay. It's awesome that it's here.
So you saw it on Steam? Is that sort of where your exposure to it was?
Yeah, I was looking for games coming up in the future, and I was like, Small World? It's going to get a PC release? I was very excited.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, it's,
you know,
good.
I don't remember if this is 100% right, but I think originally it was going to be for tablets, and if there was a certain like Kickstarter goal reached, then they were going to port it to Steam. I don't, or maybe they always intended Steam, but I think it was something like that, where they had different versions intended.
Yeah, well, I bought the tablet version. I've got an Android tablet, so I bought it for that. I bought it after buying the Steam version, but yeah, it's great. It's a great game.
Were they released at the same time, or was the Android version released earlier in the year?
I'm not sure, actually, because I didn't actually look for it until after I had the PC version.
Okay.
So I haven't played the board game, so I haven't really been exposed to the game other than through what I've read and what I've seen about the game, and it is a game that I have been looking forward to. Okay, well, let's get started, shall we? I'm just wondering whether we actually talk about our strategies or not. I guess we will.
Yeah, this is a friendly game.
Well, yeah, friendly game.
Yeah, and for me, I did want to mention this. I could not find a setting with my recording device that will allow me to pick up. I can't show it here until it's my turn, but there's going to be a screen when I click on a race that shows you what the powers of the race is and the little attachment cards with each race. For whatever reason, my recording software cannot pick up that text. So everybody watching it on my screen is just going to see a white empty box, and I'm going to have to kind of vocalize what's in that box. So, you know, it just lets you to know I'm going to have to talk a lot.
It's a shame, actually. It's something I don't know why it does that. I've got to actually turn my recording onto screen grab to actually be able to record that. So it doesn't record the game as such. It records the screen with the game actually playing in it.
That's what I'm doing as well.
Yeah, which makes it a little bit more tricky. And I guess we'll just go through, I mean, to try to explain how to play the game. The game is actually played. People can see that on my screen. I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing or not, but as we sort of go down the list of the race and attribute combinations, it will cost me a gold coin for each one that I skip over. And then they'll then be left with that particular race as a bonus for anyone who then picks them up in the future. You can see on the left-hand side of the screen here that I've got, and I guess you guys don't see this, so I'll try to rattle through this pretty fast, but you've got your attribute on the left-hand side, the race on the right-hand side, the orange circle that you see on both sides are the total numbers. Now, I'm going to go with the diplomat trolls right from the top, so I don't have to lose any of the actual things, but I really like having the troll layers because they actually add to the defense of whatever you take. And having another five trolls from the diplomat will be useful. So I'm just going to pick that. In fact, I better just quickly see what diplomats do because I don't know what they actually do. So at the end of your turn, before you click on done, you may select an opponent whose active race you did not attack this turn and choose to make peace with her. So you guys don't mind being a her, do you?
No, my avatar is actually female. I don't even know where you choose this. I did not choose that, though.
You can actually put in your own avatar.
Oh, yeah, can you?
Yeah, I have some kind of knight guy.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I should do that if we do this again, because, well, whatever. Yes. Yeah. Please continue.
All right. So it looks like you'll have to be the one that I drop the dove onto then, if you're the
one. Yes, I am the her.
So anyway, I got an extra little piece at the end if I don't attack either of you guys to actually choose who I'm going to have so that you can't attack me back. Anyway, I was going to pick this one and we'll just get into it, I guess. So I'll conquer some regions. Now, from my understanding, the natives are randomly placed. Now, I don't know if I get any bonuses from the actual trolls themselves. I don't think I do. So I don't know what races these guys will be picking. So I'm just going to, I would imagine that one of them will pick the skeletons because they seem overpowered actually. So I quite like them, but we'll just go forward. I'm just going to sort of try to get myself into a bit of a corner, I guess. And let's go this side. So we'll just start in this corner, just move up. Now I get also special attacks as well. So I think I get a bit of a bonus with attack. I can't remember exactly how that works. So I'll just grab those. Okay, then I can just redeploy my troops.
And I think it's worth noting for those who are watching that if you try to take over a province with the mountains on it, it costs an extra guy. And the same thing if you try to take over a province with the native peoples, those little Greek-looking guys with the column on the bottom left-hand corner.
Yeah, good point. You can actually see the mountain shape, which in the board game is actually a cardboard piece, I think, isn't it?
Yes, that's correct.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, well, I'm going to actually leave my forces. I'm not going to redistribute. So, oh, hang on, I've got this. So who shall I... Oh, actually, you guys aren't even on the board yet, so I can't even use my dove yet. So I'll just...
Oh, it doesn't let you?
I've got to put it on one of your pieces.
Oh, okay. I see. I didn't know that.
Okay, so those of you who are looking at my screen now we'll see the forest sorcerers, and you can see in this screen it explains the race you have on the right, and on the left it's like your special ability, and those two are tied together, but they're also random when the game starts. So you'll see here with my forest sorcerers, I collect one bonus victory coin for each forest region I occupy, and in the sorcerers attack on their own, you can conquer a region by substituting one of your opponent's tokens with one of your own. So that's the kind of their special ability. So I'm just going to go ahead and go with that. And so my goal here is going to be to conquer forests because they're worth more gold than me. So it makes sense that I would start here in the bottom right because there's two forests right next to each other. And you click your little man and you drag him over to what you want to take. So you see it takes two to hold it. And when I have this native person in the way, it takes three.
Because the sorcerer's ability only works on active races, right?
That's correct. Or at least I'm pretty sure, yeah. So you'll notice right now, if you're looking at my screen, that there's a little dice with a question mark on it. That's because it requires three tokens to take this province, but I only have two. So what's going to happen is it's going to roll a dice to see if I can take it or not. I forget, honestly, what number you need to get to make it, but the game will go, oh yeah, or oh no, depending on whether I succeed or fail.
It should indicate, actually.
It worked.
Yeah, does the little dice icon that you get, doesn't it change depending on how much you need in this game?
Oh,
yeah, we'll actually show like one, two, or three.
Yeah, I didn't even look at that. All right. Well, I won, so hooray.
Okay, so on my screen, you're going to see a white box that with no text on it. My apologies. I'm going to jump down to the skeletons and kind of just tell you to watch on my screen what they do. So, Commando, allows me to conquer any region with one less race token than normal. So for an empty region, it's typically two tokens, but with Commando, it would only require one. And the skeleton's special power is that during my troop redeployment, I can receive one new skeleton token for every two non-empty regions you conquer this turn. It's automatically added to the troops when you redeploy at the end of your turn. So I'm going to pick this, and by picking the skeletons, I bypassed the Tritons, so I had to actually pay a token or a coin to bypass them. And so I start off with 10. So my goal as a skeleton is to conquer at least two non-empty regions a turn so that I can get an additional skeleton. Let me look around the board here. Unfortunately, with the placements of Daz and Marcus, it's going to be kind of hard for me. I don't remember. Do you know if the native tribes count as well?
Yeah, no, they count.
They do? Okay, okay.
I'm not sure about the mountains, though. I don't know if the mountains count.
Good point. It does say non-empty. I don't know if empties or if mountains are considered. Oh, well, I'm going to start up here in the top right. So there you go. Took two instead of three because I am a commando. So I'll take this over. So because I took over those two that had people in it, I will get an additional skeleton at the end of my turn. And from here, I'm going to go up here.
And just so you know, Tokshen, if it makes you feel any better, on my screen, you're the old wizard guy with the horns, and Das is the blue woman.
Okay.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Tokshin's definitely the girl in mine.
what are you trying to say, Das? What are you trying to say? Okay, so now I'm in my redeployment phase, and you see that I got an additional skeleton because I conquered those two regions, so I'm going to get to redeploy this guy. I'm going to put him there. I'm going to redeploy this skeleton there, and I am going to click done. So you go, I got, was it seven? Yeah, I got seven coins for taking over seven provinces, and now Daz.
Yep. Okay, so I'm a little bit behind you guys now. So I'm three behind Tokshen and two behind Marcus Aurelius. So now I could come in and try to sort of take over some of what you guys are doing, or keep on. I sort of need to start thinking ahead a little bit, I guess, about how I'm going to be protecting my lands. And you can see the little troll there underneath each of the actual trolls. That's going to just make it a little bit harder for people to actually attack me. So I think what I might do is, I could sort of stop the forest. I might come down, actually. I'm just going to be a bit of a bastard here, Marcus. Sorry. Now, I need to...
Oh.
Two dice to get any of those, unfortunately. I only need one dice for that. I can grab this one. So I'll just go up into there, just so I can start to sort of come down a little bit closer. So now to redeploy. Well, you guys won't be able to attack from here. So I'm going to leave the four where they are. Actually, I might just move another one down across there and just be done. There we are. Oh, I forgot to do the...
Yeah, can't you use your little dove to...
I forgot about it.
Yeah, I thought you were going to hit me with the dove.
I would have, actually, because you're the only one I didn't attack.
Oh, you can only use it. Oh, that's right. So, okay. I thought maybe you could attack somebody and then use the dove on them to keep them from getting you back.
No, it would be good. I'm glad I read it, actually, because I would have thought that would have been the case. But anyway, so the poor old dove sits there.
So, do you know if I take over your fortress, do I get the benefit of it, or is it gone?
No, it's gone.
Well,
and those stay when your race is in decline, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Yeah, that's really what I'm hoping for, that I'll at least be able to pick up a little bit while I'm still in decline.
Okay.
All right.
That's what I'm counting on with that race.
Well, I would love to have that forest of yours, but you're very powerful over there, so I think I'm just going to play it a little safe. And...
So yeah, did we actually say what that die does?
No, we didn't explain it, actually.
Go ahead.
Marcus, did you want to just...
Okay. No, I can do it. So basically, as I said, if you don't have enough units, I guess you can call them units, to take over that province, the dice is your reinforcement, and it could be one, two, or three, and if you get more than what you need, you're able to conquer that province, and if you get less, you are not. Is that basically it?
Yeah, good explanation. Actually.
Yeah,
that was good.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to try and conquer two non-empty regions. I think the easiest one's going to be Marcus here in the bottom right.
Nice.
And I'll take my other two and take this native tribe. There we go. So that's going to give me an additional skeleton, as you can see, that popped down in the bottom of my screen. And I will redeploy it probably right there. And then done.
The skeletons are very strong.
They are, yeah.
There they are.
I have to peg them back. I'm going to just attack them this time.
So, hey now.
I've got four trolls, and it's sort of, I'm in two minds as to whether to actually go into decline at this point. Like, this is one of the factors of the game, is you decide when you go into decline and pick another race. And I'm thinking that I'll just continue for one more turn. It's sort of, I feel it's going to bite me, but I sort of need to push the skeletons back a little bit, I feel. So, although they're going to go into decline pretty much next turn anyway, just don't want them to get too far ahead. So let's go this way.
We are peaceful skeletons.
Actually, it's going to use all my forces to do that. For the sake of one, I'm not going to do it. I'm going to actually go into decline. I didn't get to use the Dove of Peace at all. So I'm going to send my race into decline.
And when you send a race in decline, you still earn gold for the provinces they own. You just, I guess, can't use their special abilities or conquer with them anymore.
That's right, yep. And it leaves only one of the race per tile.
Yes. But
the trolls get their troll lairs in there as well. So it leaves two for me. That's sort of why I wanted those races.
Okay.
Yeah, it's an excellent race to have into decline.
So before I go into decline, I obviously want to try my race's special ability. So I'm going to try to take this land back from Tokshen. He has two skeletons, and what this should do is it should turn one of his skeletons into one of my troops. But I guess that didn't work. Okay. I have three sorcerers remaining.
That's weird.
Yeah, I'm not sure how that mechanic works.
What?
So I guess when you try to do it, if you had done it on a skeleton or a province with only one skeleton, I think you maybe would have automatically taken it over.
But I mean, it says it's time to redeploy, but I see they moved all my guys. I get it.
Oh, bugger.
Oh, well, so much for that. Yeah, I'm really good at this game. You can all tell.
See, one of the interesting things about the game is it doesn't focus on the score as you're playing, which is quite interesting. Like, you can look at your own by clicking on it, but not anyone else's. Like, I've got no idea what score you guys actually have.
Yeah, in the board game, you turn your coin tokens upside down and kind of hoard them so nobody can see how many you have.
Yeah, it's good. It's a good. I like that they've done that in the electronic game as well.
Yeah. For this one, I don't think I can safely, because I only have three tokens left. And let's see, like, to conquer one of Marcus's, I would need at least four. Or three, I mean. Four.
You need three, I think.
What am I thinking? Yeah, I need three. So it would take all three to conquer one of his, and then for Daz's, it would take at least two. So I think it is going to be a safe time for me to go into decline. I own a lot of the map. I'm going to get a lot of points. So when you go into decline, you can't take any further action in that turn. So actually, how do you do that?
Just click on the little thing in the bottom right.
The column.
The column. Yeah.
Yeah. Here we go. Here we go.
I was trying to think of the word plinth, but column's much easier.
So there you go. Went into decline, and that's my turn.
Okay, so I guess that now merchant collect one bonus victory coin for every region you occupy at end's turn. So that's so that could potentially sort of double up, but you only get two extra for merchant. The Tritons may conquer all coastal regions, those bordering a sea or lake. So I can go right into the very middle of the map. But I think I might go have a quick look at heroic dwarves. I only start with three dwarves. So each mine region your dwarves occupy is worth one bonus victory coin at the end of your turn. This power is kept even when the dwarves are in decline. The heroic side is at the end of your turn, place each of your two heroes in two different regions you occupy. These two regions are now immune to enemy conquests and to their racial and special powers until your heroes move. your heroes disappear when you go into decline. So I'm going to go with this as much to get the extra five dwarves, because I'm going to have to start trying to focus on trying to peg Tokshen back, because he's got a bit of a lead now. So I'm going to pick those. So there's now two coins left with the Tritons. And but I also want the mountain region. So I've got eight of these to use. It's going to take me three there or three there. I think I'll go with the mountain just to try to get a little bit of extra points. Go there and hopefully take this mountain. I'm going to need to roll a two on the dice. No. Okay. So I've only got two areas there. So I'll just distribute those two, and the two heroes will, of course, I can't put them back onto the trolls, but I can protect my two areas. Okay, that's me done.
Okay.
So there you go. You see that you're getting points for declined race and your active race.
Yep.
All right. I'm going to go into decline. I was not very astutely utilizing my sorcerers.
You didn't get any extra points for the forests.
I wasn't really paying attention, but I should have. Yeah, I think once you go into decline, you lose your special ability.
Oh, okay.
All right, so merchant, yeah, you collect one bonus coin for each region you occupy. Do I want to do that? I'll also get two coins.
And you can occupy the water province, can't you?
Yeah, as the Tritons, I can occupy the water provinces. And conquer coastal regions for one less token than normal. So yeah, you know what? I will pick up the Merchant Tritons. I will pick. And let's start in the top left of the screen. I think. Yeah. Start there. Oh, whoops. Take over that for two. Take over this for one. It should be on two. And then, let's see. We only have three guys left. To conquer any of these other trolls, I think... Oh, wait, no. I'm going to conquer the troll region by the water. Because that's one less because it's touching water. There we go. And I get to redeploy troops. And... I think I want to redeploy them next to the area that has all the dwarves in it, because they seem to be pretty hostile. I don't think these are peaceful dwarves.
Yeah, but they're not focusing. Not going to focus on anything other than mountains.
So there we go. I got the points for my declined race and now also my merchant race. And I'm getting one extra coin for each of the provinces that my Tritons hold.
Wow.
Because of the merchant ability. 16 points.
That's great.
I will take that turn.
That is excellent. All right, well, we have to start pegging him back. Those merchants now actually pose a bit of a problem. What to do? I think I'll have to go this way. I've got two left here. I'd have to throw a three to get the Tritons at the bottom. I'd need to throw a three to get the Tritons at the top. So I think I'm just going to have to keep on going up against the skeletons, really, and just sort of whittle them back. No. rolled it poorly again. Okay, so I've got a couple of these to distribute. Just move them across to there. And the two heroes, just to block them off.
I rarely trust digital dice. It's nothing like the actual feel of rolling an actual die yourself.
Yeah, yep.
Okay, I think I'm going to pay the coin and go with the Swamp Ratmen. The Ratmen have no special benefit, but there's a lot of them. And Swamp is same as Forest. You get one extra bonus coin if you take over a Swamp. So I'm going to go on the offensive against the Skeletons.
Oh, the Peaceful Skeletons are just being ravaged by everybody.
And because that's two Swamps in the general vicinity. And... let's see, let's take this Plains province, and I think that's the end of me. So let's move these guys over here, and these guys over there. All right.
I love how with the simple mechanics, they've been able to actually capture each race, and it feels like you actually are playing these sort of fantasy races.
Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah, it's excellent. Mm. I agree. I love how they've done the races in this game. Okay, so now I'm thinking, everybody's, you know, ganging up on my peaceful skeletons. Now, I only have 3 provinces left of my skeletons. So if I would go into decline with my Tritons, that would kick off my skeletons from the board. So do I want to try and conquer with 4 remaining tokens of Tritons? Or do I want to just go into decline now? Let me think about this. So I would only need 3 there to conquer the coastal region from the trolls. Then I would get 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I think it's worth... I'm going to keep the Tritons around for another turn. We'll conquer this troll region there, and I'm going to... I guess try to roll the die against the troll region to the right of it. I'm going to need a 2. Oh, I got it!
Well, well done.
I was lucky. I actually got the reinforcements there.
The first dice roll that worked out.
Yeah. I'm going to redeploy my troops to defend myself against these dwarves as best I can, and then I'm going to end my turn. So my merchant ability is really just doing a lot of work here.
It's fantastic, actually. It's been great. I mean, you've got pretty more than 16. I haven't been counting, but 15, wow. 2 great turns. Okay, well, I would have gone to the mountain regions over on the right-hand side, you know, middle right, but I can't afford to do that. I've got to stop you. So I'm going to have to come back through here. I've only got 1 of these left. Ooh. I'll have to roll a 3 back through here or a 2 there. I think I'm just going to have to go for attrition, really, and just try to stop you. Oh, I only threw a 1. Okay. let's see. We'll go there.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't think we actually talked about how combat works, like how you lose tokens. So for example, when Daz took over my region, on my screen at least, you would have saw 1 of the Triton tokens went to the bottom of my screen, because you can only ever actually lose 1 token when your province is taken. The other tokens are going to be put back into a pool for you to use at the start of your next turn. So I've only 1 of my Tritons of the 2 that were there were actually, you know, technically killed. Yeah, that's how combat works.
Okay, so...
Or deaths.
I'm not sure about you guys, but I think I have too many open programs here, because mine is lagging like crazy. But I'm going to continue my assault against the peace-loving skeletons.
Oh!
And,
Just leave them 1.
I guess they're going to... they're all going to be gone next turn anyway, right?
Yeah, they will be, yeah. Oh, the skeletons are gone.
But still, that merchant ability, that's a good ability.
Yeah.
Because you figure
that was a good turn for you.
My forest ability and my swamp ability is limited, obviously, by the number of forests and swamps in the map, and you never can conquer the whole map, so the most you can get from it maybe is 2, maybe 3 if you're lucky, but the merchant, it doesn't matter what you conquer, you get the extra coin, right?
Exactly. Yeah. And yep. With the water in the center and the water on the edges, it really makes it easy with the Tritons especially to conquer, you know, those regions next to water. So I think it's merchant Tritons are a pretty good combination.
Yeah, actually it's been incredible, really. I mean, the amount of points you got from those has been phenomenal just in a couple of turns.
And I think for this turn, I'm going to go into decline. I only have 2 more Triton tokens, and my previous race that was in decline has been destroyed. So I think it's best for me to just say goodbye to my Tritons. There they go. So now I do not get the merchant ability. The special ability for my race is now gone. So that time I only collected 5, which is not that great, but I'll take it.
And then that actually frees me up a bit, because I no longer have to worry about the overkill, like the overabundance of coinage coming back through Tokshen's forces. So I can afford to actually now try to get some extra points for myself. So I'm going to actually just go and keep this open 1 more turn at least, and go for the middle. I can go for 1 more. I want to now start to... I've got to peg someone else back. I'm going to need to roll a 2 on any of these. I'm going to go with the swamp at the top, just to try to sort of kill that input off, I guess, or the income of the swamps. Yeah, I got there. Okay, so
there you go.
finally the dice had to come back around. So I'm going to actually go and stop Marcus from actually being able to retake that particular place. I don't know if I can still move these around. I can. Okay, so I'll go back into here as well. A little bit away from where these guys can be. So let's just throw in that one there. Okay, that will do.
That was a good move with the heroic token on the swamp there.
Yeah, I hope it stops. I mean, it has to stop the Marcus from attacking back.
Oh, I don't know if we covered this either, nice. But you've probably noticed the crown marker that shows whose turn it is. This game actually only goes for 10 turns. So right now you can see we're on turn 7 of 10. I don't know if we mentioned that at the beginning or not.
No, yeah, you're right. I don't think we did.
Yep.
Okay, so I think I'm done with the ratmen, so I'm just going to reinforce my swamps. Well, it's what's left of my swamps. And that'll be it for me.
Those sorcerers still pulling in some income. 7 turns into the game.
Actually, I just realized I've been going for mountains. I should have been going for mines.
Oh, yeah, for the dwarven ability?
Yeah, I would have gone.
Yeah.
Actually, would have played them very differently. I actually thought it was the mountains I got income for.
I decided not to say anything.
Well, it's a game. Why not?
Let me see. Who do I want to go for? So for fortified, once per turn, as long as your fortified race is active, you may place one fortress in a region you occupy. The fortress is worth 1 bonus victory coin unless I'm in decline. The fortress also increases the defense of that province by 1. I can place 1 per turn. I think that's pretty cool. I'm mostly reading this for the people watching. I kind of know what all these people do, but
yeah, it's good that actually when you read it out, at least we can then like our viewers, I guess, are also sharing what you're strategizing and what you're thinking.
And I appreciate it too, since it's been a while since I've played.
And let me see. I think I'm going to pick up these Spirit Amazons. So Spirit. When the race tokens associated with your spirit's special power go into decline, so when this race is in decline, they never count toward the limit regarding having a single race into decline. So normally you can have one active race and one race in decline, but with spirits, I could technically have 2 races in decline. My spirit race and then whatever other race I have. Although at this point in the game,
we are on
turn 7, that's actually not going to happen yet, so maybe I shouldn't do that.
Yeah, there's some abilities...
I
was going to say there's some abilities that are lucky if you get at the beginning of the game, and then some that are lucky if you get at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be great at the start, wouldn't it?
Let me see here. So Stout, I don't even know what that is. I haven't actually played with that. You may go into decline at the end of a regular turn of conquests after scoring. Wow.
Well, that's nice. That would be good, actually, at this time of the game.
Yeah, because I could do an entire round of conquest and then go into decline. Well, you know, I don't want to spend all that money to get down to wizards, though. I'm going to be a little greedy. I'm going to go with the orcs who are fortified. See if I can go with them to the end of the game. So I think I'm going to start by going after these wizards who have just been kind of hanging out in the forests down here. And let me see. I'll need a 1 to conquer any of these regions. I will conquer this rat region because I believe Marcus is going to go into decline, so this is actually what's going to affect him the most. And I actually got it. Okay.
Wow, all you needed was a 1, so there's no way you could lose. Oh, I guess you could roll a 0.
Yeah, there's 3
Yeah, you
zeros.
Can roll a 0.
It's 50-50.
So in my redeployment phase, I can now place this one fortress. I'm going to place it... Oh boy. I'll place it right here, and then I think that'll be it.
Man, look at those coins roll in.
Oh, I didn't even go and say what the orcs' ability was. Because they actually get a victory point, an additional victory point, if they conquer a non-occupied region, or an occupied region.
Oh, okay.
Right? Because they have, like, the pillaging effect.
Now with 8 at turn 8 now, it's the start of the 8th turn, so I'm just going to go straight into decline here, and I'll lose my trolls. I've still got 3 troll areas. I'm sort of kicking myself I didn't actually go after the mines and went after the mountains instead. So anyway, we'll go into decline at this point.
I think when I first started playing the board game, I remember making that mistake too. I assumed the dwarves were just mountain people and not mines as well.
Yeah, oh well, live and learn.
Now, one thing cool that I think I'm remembering correctly is if, like, Das, this province you have with your decline dwarf with the little gray circle with the white kind of entrance, those are caves, and you can travel from one cave to another? Or there's a special ability that lets you travel from one cave to another?
Yeah, there's some races, I think.
Yeah, actually, I think... Is it the Ratman who can travel through caves? There is a race that can travel through caves, and I think there's a special power that allows you to travel through the caves.
Yeah, the Ratman's special power is just that there's a lot of them.
Okay, so it must just be the one of the powers there. Okay, so I'm just verifying the orc's special ability here. Yeah, each non-empty region your orcs conquer is worth 1 bonus victory coin. Okay. So, whoops. Do you want to leave this game now? No. I accidentally pressed escape. All right, so I want to go after these ratmen because those are regions that have people in it, so I'll get additional victory points. So I'll go for there, and I will try for this ratman in the center. And I got enough reinforcements to take it. I got an additional fortress. I'm going to put that down here, and I'm going to redeploy. You're going to notice that I'm redeploying in regions that are in the edge of the map, because I know that in most cases when a race comes into play, you have to start at the edge of the map. So, like, I know that my orc province that has the plains that I took at the very last there, that's kind of protected. So that's why I'm just fortifying my coastal provinces. There we go. Turn's done.
And it's my turn, and because you're so far ahead, I'm going to have to sort of target you to a degree anyway. So, yeah, it's a good move to strengthen those. Wow, look at that. 14. You're so far ahead. Okay, I'm looking at the pillaging orcs. Pillaging elves. So each non-empty region you conquer is worth, this turn is worth 1 bonus victory coin. Okay, so when the enemy conquers one of your regions, you keep all your elf tokens. Having 11 of those, that's probably the only thing I can really do to sort of try to sort of combat what Tokshen's got. So I've got an extra 2 coins there as well because people have bypassed them. I think I'll go with those. Spirit Amazons, as we discussed, the spirit ability is just not really worth it. And I was looking at wealthy humans just to get the extra 7, but I'm so far behind anyway. I think I'm really the best bet for me is just to try to conquer and make it difficult for Tokshen. So I'll just
go. I think pillaging elves is a very good choice with all the elves you can get with that.
And I can sort of come up through here and also grab some tritons and things as well. So I'll come up through the. I can only go. You can see there it's red if I actually hover over the inland, but I can come through any of the outer regions of the map. So I'm going to attack the orcs here and then the tritons. And I don't know whether to go, which way to go here. I'll go with tritons, which are safe, and then ratmen needing 2. No, missed it. Okay. And just push that one down there.
So I would imagine, I've never gotten this combination, but pillaging orcs, I imagine you would get 2 victory points for each non-empty region you would conquer, because orcs have pillaging built into their special to their race. So that could be pretty nasty if that ever comes up.
That would be, wouldn't it?
I am going to pick the wealthy humans. It only cost me 2 coins to get 7. That's kind of a no-brainer. And again, as we discussed, the spirit Amazons and the stout wizards, not so useful at this stage in the game. But what I do want is I want some farmlands. Because that's what.
Oh, right, because humans get, 1 bonus victory point. Is that right?
Yes, correct.
Okay.
All right, so that's pretty much what I wanted to do. I will redeploy one of these here, and that's good for me. So really, I've just been the guy who's been using the special terrain abilities.
Oh, that was nice.
17, very nice. So far.
Nice work.
All right, so we're on turn 9 of 10. So this is my last chance to go into decline if I want to. Seeing as how most of my previous race is gone... So I either just play an additional 2 rounds with the orcs or I go into decline. I only have 3 tokens to play with. And it would take all 3 to conquer just one region, so that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ooh, decisions.
You've only got one Triton left as well, haven't you?
Yeah.
Now
I'm gonna
I was just gonna say, what would be neat is if for the digital version of this game, they had a ton of different backgrounds. Because in the board game, obviously, you have like 2 choices depending on how many players there are. But it'd be cool if now that it's digital, they're not limited by that, that there's like a ton of different backgrounds or playing boards.
Maps to play on?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, that would be pretty awesome.
That would be excellent.
This is so tough. But I think I'm going to go into decline and try to... Yeah, I'm going to go into decline. This may be a bad choice.
No, I think it's about all you could really do. But otherwise, you're going to basically lose your... Actually, you don't have many points from that one.
Yeah, no, I only got 4.
Yeah.
I could have got, I think, about 10 if I did not go into decline.
Yeah, I would have gone into decline at that point, I think, simply because, you know, like it at least gives you another turn with a fresh race at the very end.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's do some damage over this side. Jeez, I'm not rolling those dice very well.
Yeah, has it given you 1 at all in this?
Yeah,
in this
I got
game?
1.
It did? Okay.
That'll do me. So that's my last turn.
Oh yeah, it is. Oh gosh, I forgot I'm the very last player.
And obviously there's no more farmlands for my humans to be able to conquer, so I'm just going to play it safe, leave you gentlemen alone, and conquer the neutral provinces. Oh, actually, I do have 2. Oh, there's another neutral.
Yeah, I think that's
excellent.
Good move.
And all right, well, let's see what kind of terror Tokshen pulls off with his new race.
I'm looking at the Amazons. Even though the spirit doesn't do anything for me, I'm still going to get 11 Amazons.
Yeah.
I'll go over what the Amazons do. So you get 4 additional Amazon tokens for conquest only. So I would technically have 15 Amazons to conquer for this turn. That's a lot.
It's a hell of a lot. That's good.
So I'm going to choose them. There we go. I got 15 tokens to do my last turn here. And I think the easiest is going to be going after the rats and go along the north there. I think that would be the easiest.
And you technically don't harm us because we've already earned our last coins. We're not going to earn any more coins after this.
Yeah, so in my last turn, I don't have to worry about, you know, okay, I know that Daz is ahead or Marcus is ahead, so I have to target them. I can just go whatever is the easiest path. That's kind of the benefit of being the very last person. Oh. Yeah, I think I'm going to go with this. So we'll start up here in the corner. Take that. And then I think the safest is going to be this mountain over here. And then I don't really need to redeploy, so I'll just hit done. And here we go.
You still had 4 left, did you? Or is that, or did I just happen to look up at the very end?
I see 4 as well.
Those 4 go back into, those are the 4 that I can use for conquest, but they go back into my pool at the end.
Well, I don't think this is a big surprise.
Points. That's great.
Whew. I've never seen this screen. That's a cool victory screen with all the pile of coins. Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Well, that was a great game.
Yeah.
And we've done it under the hour, which is good. So actually, that'd be good to do that again and sometime in the future, actually. It was very, very enjoyable.
Yeah, it's a quick little game.
Yeah, I would love to keep playing. I love Small World. I could play this for, well, maybe not hours and hours, but I would definitely look forward to another game.
Yeah. Yeah, unfortunately, I can't do it right now, but I would love to do this again in the near future.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna do some 80s montage style training.
Small world training. Okay. So I guess you can maybe expect more of this in the future then.
Oh, I would on our love channels. To.
Yeah. I'd love to. All right, gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Marcus. Thanks, Tokshen. And thanks, viewers.
Have a good one, everyone.